Greetings everyone, and welcome to the SMOOREZ Archive. These are just all my old videos that I took down that I am re-releasing with some slight edits here and there. I did these DHGate Cheapo sneaker reviews for entertainment and educational purposes, and I do not endorse the sales of any Replica products whatsoever. No links to any of these items will be given since these videos were done ages ago anyways. Well, I hope you do get a kick out of my old content.
Hello YouTube, let's get started on this one. We have this box right here. So the shoes in this package were $47, I believe, off DHGate, and one commenter by the name of, I'll put your name here, asked me to review these, and I had a little bit of a Google, and I went, okay, they look interesting, so I may as well. So I've heard of the brand and the collaborator, Versace, and 2 Chainz, not actual 2 Chainz, but the artist 2 Chainz, this bloke here. They collaborated and made the Chain Reaction shoes, and they just looked very outlandish and just thought, let's have a look. And sure enough, DHGate had plenty of options to choose from, so here we are. And the only reason why I have heard of 2 Chainz is because of a song from Skrillex and Diplo when they made the whole Jack U collaboration thing. They made a song called Febreze, and that had 2 Chainz in it, so that's the only thing I know of 2 Chainz. That's it. I don't know of any other songs he's made, so I'm very sorry about that. My musical taste in hip-hop isn't really that great at the moment, so I apologize for that. So let's go ahead and open this box. So I know what the box is supposed to look like, so I wonder if it's gonna look like that or not. All right, people. It says Versace, but it's kind of upside down at the moment. We see Chainz, so good things. Yay! There it is. And I can't read it. Oh yeah, I can see it. Chain Reaction there. Okay. A little bit of dust on it, but otherwise, it's the box that I have seen on the web, so that is good. All right, on the side of the box, we have the little sticker that says Snicker Mix. I'm not good at Italian, sorry. The codes and stuff, size 45, that should fit me fine. So some text just here that says founded in teen. It's sort of covered by the sticker. 78, conceived in Milan, Italy. So there you go, the brand was conceived there. That's interesting. Anyways, on the bottom of the box, we have already seen that. On the side of the box, we have Versace. And you know what? For me, the box does not look like a Versace thing. Versace's like, you know, Gucci, Louis Vuitton, all that sort of stuff, you know, supposed to be really luxurious and stuff. This just looks like a generic sort of pair you would pick up from like Walmart or Kmart or something like that. You know what I'm saying, you know? The box just doesn't look that great. All right, let's open this box because I have been eagerly awaiting to see these shoes. All right, here we go. Okay, that's not what I was expecting, but fair enough. There's supposed to be a dust bag. We will see. There's no dust bag. Unless they call the plastic bag a dust bag, which could be fair. Anyways, move along. Shoes! Yay! Alright, let's have a look at some $47 Chain Reactions. Oh, they actually feel quite nice. Hoo-hoo! Oh my god. The first reaction I'm gonna say with these shoes is, wow, I was not expecting them to be like this. Okay, we have a lot to cover here. This shoe has an amazing amount of detail. It's not just a straight out shoe like a Yeezy that's just like, you know, upper sole, you know, the insole and stuff. We have like 20 million things to cover on this shoe. Let's start with the tags first. So we have the sneaker mix, yada yada yada, all that sort of stuff. Nothing there. Then we have, check the authenticity of this product at versace.certalogo.com. Hands up if you think nothing's gonna come of that, unless it does. Anyways, there's a tag there, Versace, with the little logo there. Ooh, look at that, shiny. Looking good. Definitely, I was not expecting them to be like this for the amount I paid. Just wow. Alright, so around the toe box here, we have the braille writing. I don't know what that says, actually. I think it's supposed to be love. I'm not too sure. Didn't do my research. Actually, I did do my research, I just can't remember what it says. Then we have this little sort of maze pattern here, this little square sort of pattern there. That's a rubber sort of filling material. Then we have this mesh design all here, looking good, and then some suede. Moving on to the side here with this design here with the shoelace loops. It says the Versace right there, sticks out a little bit. All the shoelaces, which look like the Triple S ones. I've seen these laces on so many different shoes. Maybe it's a designer brand thing, you know, Balenciaga had them. But anyways, having a look around, and on the back here, this is great, this is gorgeous here. That's the face of the brand of Versace. While it doesn't look terrible, it doesn't look fantastic either. Look, I'll give it credit, these are $47 shoes. At least it's not like completely messed up, it does look like a face. Then moving around to the other side of the shoe, we can see the Versace logo branding again, as well as this pattern. Feels like a sort of a rubber synthetic material. Feels quite strong, doesn't feel like it's gonna go anywhere. There's also two sort of bits of it. There's like a leather underneath and then rubber there, so okay. Fairly well constructed. The tongue sort of reminds me of an Air Max shoe with this sort of, see how that goes around there? Just reminds me of an Air Max 97 is what it reminds me of. There's a Chain Reaction logo there, which is rubber. Looks quite solid to me. There's little lightning bolts and stuff. And that looks pretty good. And then there's all the little detail on the tongue and all that sort of stuff. So that's all looking fairly good. Look, I'm fairly impressed with the shoes already. The shoelace tips have these, you know what? I'm just going to leave it to your little imagination as to what these look like, but I'm mature, so I'm not going to say anything about them. The tongue continues down with its little sort of pattern here and all the patterns. There's a lot of patterns, and it's amazing how many patterns there are on this shoe. It's just patterns everywhere. The shoelace also keeps, hang on. Oh no, that's just a little bit of lacing to go through the back of the pull tab here, which is all leather. This is leather. Feels quite strong. Doesn't feel like the shoe's going to fall apart, so that's good. We haven't even got to inside of the shoe yet, which is full of cushioning and all that sort of stuff. So moving to the sole, I'm going to say that this is the Versace pattern, but that goes around there and then goes around there like that. And then the sole is a really outlandish sole. It is like a chain because, you know, two chains and stuff. There is a fair amount of grip to it, and also it's very, very soft. Very, very nice and soft. So it's a dad shoe sort of thing, but it's also got that element of fashion, luxury. It's kind of like a Balenciaga shoe sort of thing. Cross Gucci, cross any other shoe that sort of looks like this. That was a great comparison to make. There's the little face again there, which doesn't look quite great, but hey, look, it looks like a face if you kind of look at it from that angle. So I'll give it that. It does kind of look like it. I'm actually a big fan of this. I actually really, really like this. It's strange, it's unique, but hey, I like it. That thing actually feels metal. No, it's rubber. Well, there you go. So have a look at the tongue here. 45 made in Italy. I was expecting it to say a little bit more than 45 made in Italy, but that's okay. And then, yeah, inside the shoe, there's all this cushioning and stuff. I would assume that these are definitely going to be very, very comfortable, but holy crap, you can just feel it. The amount of cushioning is just crazy. Anyways, is the sole removable? It is. Okay. And of course, it says Chain Reaction. And then it has Versace written there, as well as the, that way, the branding. Okay, that one doesn't look the best. There you go, that's yeah, that's a little jacked. But look, no one's gonna see that because it's gonna be inside of the shoe, so that is all good. But otherwise, made in Italy there. A lot of detail. Yoga mat foam insole, of course. But hey, it's got a bit of cushioning to it, so it's all good. Otherwise, inside of the shoe is the usual cross stitching. Looks clean. Can't really see anything that I can complain about. Once again, all that cushioning. The shoes are just cushioning. A little pull tab on the tongue there. I'm just still amazed at all the detail and stuff that they've packed onto this shoe. Like all the stitching along here with a little leather sort of stripe going around here. Mesh detailing to the rubber, to the branding. My God. But that profile is just amazing. They just look really, really, really cool. On to the next one, which is basically exactly the same. It has the same braille writing. Everything looks practically the same on this shoe. There's no inserts or tissue paper inside of the shoe, which they kind of should have put some in there, but that's okay. The shoe's maintained its shape during shipping, which is okay. Plus, it'll probably pop up once I put my foot in there. Does it feel like a $2,000 shoe? Probably not. But I didn't even notice this. Just there. On the toe box, it says Versace. But then I've also noticed some glue marks there. A little bit more there. Probably more going, yeah, there's a lot of glue marks. A few glue marks here and there versus the amount of detail and stitching and all that sort of stuff on the shoe. I'll ignore it for now. There's also some creasing on the soles. Not that you can see it at the moment because of the exposure. Just there. That's not a big problem. They're going to crease anyways, like the Balenciaga sock trainers. They had all the creasing in them. Well, I think it is time to finally try on these Versace Chain Reaction shoes because I can't wait to put them on foot and show you guys what they look like. But these are definitely really cool shoes. Something I didn't think I would like, but I do like them now. I mean, there are so many other different colorways and choices for these shoes at the moment, but I thought just, you know, black and white would just be very standard for me. And My God, they look cool. But anyways, I'll put them on foot, do an on-foot segment, and then we'll finally give a conclusion to this video and what I think of these shoes. I've already said what I think of these shoes. Anyways, I'm rambling. Let's cut to the on-foot segment now.
And here are the Versace Chain Reaction kicks on foot. I assumed while making the video that these would be comfortable and, well, I was right. As well as adding at least a few inches to my height due to the massive sole, I have to say from these to a pair of Ultra Boost kicks, I would definitely prefer these. Walking in the Chain Reaction shoes feels like I have a heap of pillows strapped to my feet. They are a very nice fit, not loose and not tight, just right, which is awesome. They are also very lightweight, plenty of grip from that chainsole, which as I mentioned is very unique. The profile is the definitive shining moment for these shoes because of all the details, that massive sole as I said, and to the little bits of branding here and there, it is a very effective shoe and will definitely turn heads. Is it worth the cost though? Maybe, but at least you can see what a pair would look like on foot.
Alright guys, and that is the on-foot segment for the Versace Chain Reaction shoes done, and as I said in the on-foot segment, I am absolutely impressed with these, with the amount I paid for them. These are probably the best shoes I have got off DHGate so far. You guys might be able to tell some differences, but as far as I can see between images on Google and all that sort of stuff, these look fairly solid to me. Very, very happy with these. Just didn't get the dust bag, which is a little bit disappointing because it said it comes with a dust bag, but hey, I got a box instead. I'd rather a box. So that will be the end of this review. I hope you guys enjoyed this one. It's been a work in progress and yeah, here we are. Thank you for 2k subscribers. Well, we're kind of near 2k, but I'll just say thank you at this point. I appreciate it very much. We were at 2.3 on the old channel and now we're at 2 on this one. So thank you very much. I must be doing something right. Thank you all. Be good people. Be kind to one another. Respect each other. All that sort of stuff. Please be good in the comments and I'll see you all in the next video, whatever that may be. But I know what it'll be, but I usually say whatever that may be to end the videos because that's what I usually say. Anyways, I'm rambling. All right. Hope you enjoyed this. See you next time.
Hey, thanks for watching this video. If you made it to the end, you got through some really cringy old s'mores. If you liked it though, leave a like. If not, then feel free to dislike. I'll see you in the next one.